But this is exactly the same question, Arvind and Dr. Bedi, that is asked about politicians, that there is a sense of nepotism, the allegation is. And the politicians come up with the same response, that they come from a political family and therefore are politically equipped to do the job. It's the same allegation which is now being leveled against you.
No, that's exactly what I'm trying to say, that in politics, when the son comes into politics, he gains access there because he is the son of a such and such person. So that is his only qualification. Here, these two individuals, I think through these debates, we are demeaning their contribution to the society. These are the people who are so eminent. These are the people who have fought against corruption at so many places. This debate of father and son is so unnecessary that
Dr. Bedi, is it an unfair question? Or do you think...
It's an unfair question. Do you know what? What are they coming for? Cabinet position? Are they coming for cabinet? Are they getting a red light car? Are they getting a bungalow? Are they getting any salary? What are they getting? Absolute dedication to a cause without any remuneration. It's going to be next, the whole of April, rest of April, May, June. That means the next almost 100 days, they're going to dedicate themselves to the cause. And they all have a lot of their own work. And they both have already invested voluntarily behind the scene a lot of time into this case, into the law, into drafting this law after doing research, as Anna was saying. So they happen to be a father and a son, but the fact is they both have collectively dedicated themselves to this national cause.
The fact is it's incidental they happen to be,
but they've been dedicated, and they never knew that this such, they were never waiting to become a member of a committee. They did it despite and with no expectations. But even the committee is not a position. It's another dedication.
I have a feeling these two guys are very tough negotiators.
Yes.
And they are very thorough with the law. I have a feeling this debate has been very successfully planted by the government in the media. And the media has lapped it up. With the hope that somehow we'll be persuaded to get one of them out. And that is what the government wants.
You won't do that.
We will not do that.
Or one of them.
Despite all the criticism that you keep on doing, we will not do it. These two people will be in because these are our biggest assets in this committee. I'm really scared some one day Prashant or Shanti Bhushanji just might say, I don't want to win the committee. I'm really scared of that.
Then the country will be the loser.
The country will be the loser. Rahul, you will be the loser. Your children will be the loser.
Yes.
That is what the government wants. They don't want tough negotiators inside. They want very pliable people.
They are knowledgeable and
tough. So please, Rahul, we want support from you. We want support from the entire media. We want support from the people of this country that don't get into this trap. The government has very successfully planted this trap in the entire country.
Okay, we'll leave that debate on the side. I want to come to, ab iske aage kya? Aapne jis tarike se shantipurna kranti ki, haal ke saalon mein isko kranti hi kahenge. Ab Anna Hazare jis mudde ko chhuenge, जनता उनके पीछे आएगी. तो अब अन्ना हजारे इसके बाद आगे किस मुद्दे को किस स्वरूप में उठाना चाहते
हैं? नहीं, इस मुद्दे का जैसे आप ये लोकपाल बिल की बात है, लोकपाल हो गया, ठीक है. आगे जो करना है देश के लिए, तो हम अभी इसका एक अच्छा संगठन बनाना जरूरी है. दूसरा, इलेक्ट्रिक जो तुम अपना SMS है और ये बातें है, उसमें से भी हम पूरे देश को कैसे संपर्क बनाए, तो अभी से ये शुरू कर रहे हैं कि SMS उसमें ज्वाइंट होने वाले लोग कौन है क्या. फिर हम जाएंगे उस स्टेट में, हर स्टेट में जाएंगे और वो लोगों के जो नाम हमारे पास आए उनको पहले बताएंगे कि इस तारीख को, इस डेट को हम वहाँ आ रहे हैं, तो वो लोग भी वहाँ आ जाएंगे. फिर उनके बारे में हम देखेंगे कि कौन लोग इसमें जो अच्छे है, चारित्रशील है, आचार विचार उनके अच्छे है, ऐसे लोगों को सिलेक्शन करके फिर एक स्टेट से लेकर डिस्ट्रिक्ट तक. नीचे तो हम नहीं जा सकते, इतना हमारे पास वो पैसा भी नहीं, धन नहीं, दौलत नहीं और उतना समय भी नहीं, लेकिन यहाँ तक हम जाएंगे और ऐसे एक संगठन करेंगे. डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल पर गए तो नीचे ऑटोमेटिक जाएगा वो, जैसे हम लोग बनाए महाराष्ट्र में 33 डिस्ट्रिक्ट, 252 ब्लॉक में हमारा संगठन है. सरकार का नाक दबाने से मुंह खुल जाता है, वो काम करना है.